Hey guys, it's Chris. From bridges that collapsed due to nature to one of the scariest events in human history, here are 9 epic engineering disasters. Number 9. Tacoma Narrows Bridge Collapse. Bridges are both an engineering marvel and something that causes some people to be absolutely terrified. In fact, the fear of bridges is called your fire phobia, and to be fair, it's not hard to see why. For while bridges are often constructed to be magnificent and allow people and vehicles to cross unimpeded, it does make you wonder at times what would happen if they weren't, or if something happened to go wrong and cause them to collapse. Such is what happened with the Tacoma Narrows Bridge. This simple bridge was opened in 1940 to get people from A to B, but on November 7th, not even 4 months after it was constructed, it was brought down by something many didn't expect, the wind. Well, it was a wind force of significant strength that exposed a flaw in the bridge, and that caused it to bend and sway until eventually the whole structure just fell down. As you can see in the video, this wasn't a simple movement, but a brutal one that forced the bridge to be ripped apart. The first incident occurred around 11 a.m. when concrete dropped from the surface of the road, and just a few minutes later, a 600-foot section of the bridge broke free. By this time, the bridge was being tossed back and forth pretty violently. There were even moments when the elevation of the sidewalk on one side of the bridge was 28 feet above that of the sidewalk on the other side. Even though the bridge towers were made of strong, durable, structural carbon steel, the bridge proved to be no match for the wind movement, and it collapsed. The only good thing about this incident was that no people were harmed in the incident. A dog was killed, though, and that is tragic. Regardless of the loss of life, the destruction of the bridge made many bridge builders more respectful of nature and how it can wreck their creations. On October 14, 1950, after more than 2 years of construction, a replacement bridge opened. It's 40 feet longer than the original and the 5th longest suspension bridge in the United States. Number 8. Boston Molasses Disaster. No, you didn't hear that wrong. I said molasses disaster, and yes, this really did happen. The catastrophe happened in Boston, and it was something that few would ever have expected. You see, on a street in Boston, there was a massive container of molasses. In fact, it had about 2.3 million gallons of molasses in it. So what happened? Well, in 1919, the tank holding all that molasses collapsed, and it poured out all the thick, dark syrup onto the outlying areas. Now, lest you think that molasses isn't deadly, remember that there was literally a couple millions of gallons of that sticky stuff in the tank. There was so much molasses that a nearby train actually got pushed off the tracks. And because people weren't prepared for the disaster, 150 people were injured and 21 people died. Death by molasses! Which brings me to, who's to blame? Well, pretty much everyone who built that tank, actually. Immediately following the mishap, news coverage included speculation about fermentation that produced way too much pressure inside the tank. It was poorly constructed from top to bottom, and multiple people near the incident claimed that they heard rivets popping out that sounded like machine guns. Plus, the tank itself was barely tested, both in terms of having things in it and seeing how the weather would hurt the metal. The heat in Boston warped the tank until a crack formed, and it grew until eventually it opened the literal floodgates. Number 7. Indian Power Grid Failure. For a more recent engineering disaster, let's head to India in 2012. During June of that year, there were some terrible monsoons, which actually arrived much later season-wise than anyone had expected. As such, the people of India had a much bigger need, the need for electricity, which is totally understandable. However, because of the demand, a set of circuit breakers were tripped in the Bina-Gwalior line, and due to that, 22 states in India were blacked out. And not just for an hour or two, but for 2 whole days. It's important to remember that India has one of the biggest populations in the entire world. They're second only to China. This blackout affected a whopping 620 million people for 2 whole days. And you might be wondering, how is this an engineering disaster? Well, it's because the system itself didn't have a backup or a fallback option. So thus it took them 2 whole days to get the power back up for these people that probably really missed flushing toilets and their refrigerators keeping their food fresh. Thankfully, after this incident occurred, the Indian government took steps to not just better protect their electrical system, but to ensure that this never happens again. It's probably a smart move on the government's part, eh? Have you ever lost electricity for that long? I think the longest I've ever gone is maybe a few hours. What did you do if it went longer? Let me know in the comments below, and while you're at it, Like this video and hit that subscribe button too. Number 6. St. Francis Dam. St. Francis Dam was once located about 40 miles northwest of downtown Los Angeles in the Sunshine State of California. It was built between 1924 and 1926 as a curved concrete gravity dam in order to connect LA's growing need for water regulation and storage. It spanned 1,300 feet and held more than 12 billion gallons of water. It was designed and built by the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power under the direction of its general manager and chief engineer, a self-taught American-Irish man named William Mulholland. From the day the dam opened in 1926, it leaked. People in the town close by used to joke and say, "I'll see you later if the dam don't break." Little did they know how that small joke would soon become the second greatest disaster in Californian history in terms of loss of life. 3 minutes to midnight on March 12, 1928, the dam broke, releasing a 10-story-high avalanche of water to sweep 54 miles west to the ocean. It would take over 5 hours to get there, but there wasn't an official warning sounded for more than an hour after the catastrophic rupture. The result was over 450 people killed by the flood. Whole towns, dozens of ranches, 1,200 houses, and 10 bridges were engulfed by water. Poor design and the use of poor quality concrete, which allowed water to undermine the dam's foundations, were to blame. The disaster marked the end of Mulholland's career. Number 5. The Challenger Explosion. As sad as it may sound, there are numerous engineering disasters that I could have put here in regards to space travel. There's the horror of the Apollo 1 mission, where the astronauts were trapped inside the shuttle while a fire burned them alive. There's the Apollo 13, where the astronauts were almost killed because of a defective part causing them to improvise while in space. But few disasters can match what happened with the Challenger shuttle. This shuttle had already been on multiple missions, and in fact, the 1986 one would have been its 10th mission, which is why it was viewed live on television. Also important to note was that there was a civilian among the flight crew, a first for the program. But 76 seconds into the flight, the shuttle exploded. The whole world saw the disaster happen right before their eyes, and everyone mourned the loss of the 7-person crew. How could this have happened? It wasn't a new ship, and it was regularly checked as it should have been. So what occurred on this specific day of the launch? After a deep investigation, it was determined that the O-rings that sealed the rocket boosters were compromised the morning of the flight because the temperature got too cold. Engineers had actually warned the NASA bosses about this, but it was ignored because they felt it would be all right. Probably should trust science and hard facts over feeling for this type of thing. Cost 7 people their lives, and millions around the world went from watching a triumph to witnessing a tragedy. After this explosion, NASA shut down all manned flights into space for some time. Number 4. Hyatt Regency Hotel Walkway Collapse. Hotels are places where you're meant to relax and have fun as you stay there for a work trip or while you're on vacation. But in 1981, one of the greatest structural tragedies in U.S. history occurred. For 2 walkways in the hotel collapsed suddenly, and it took the lives of 114 people with them. There were also 200 people injured because of the collapse. So how did this happen? Well, there was a dance contest at the Hyatt Regency Hotel in Kansas City, Missouri. Many people and spectators watched the event from various walkways in the hotel. On the surface, that's fine, as the walkways are meant to support a lot of weight. However, the engineers of these particular walkways decided to cut some corners, and the walkways on the 4th and 2nd floors of the hotel were not constructed to support all that weight. With so many people packed on them watching the dancing, it was only a matter of time before they collapsed. The engineers of these walkways were arrested and sent to court for crimes of gross negligence and misconduct. They were convicted of both counts and were stripped of their licenses, as they should be. Number 3. Hindenburg. Oh, the humanity. Aviation has gone through so many different phases over the years, and one of the most interesting of them all was the arrival of blimps and zeppelins, also known as airships. These vessels were actually engineering marvels, as it proved that as long as you had enough light gas in the proper frame, you could float pretty much anything you wanted off the ground. That is, until the Hindenburg came crashing down. The ship was supposed to be the pinnacle of airship travel, and was coming all the way from Germany to New Jersey when it suddenly caught fire. Within about 36 seconds, the entire massive airship was gone, burned to a crisp in what must have been one of the most terrifying things ever witnessed by man. To this day, the destruction of Hindenburg is a piece of history just about everyone knows about. But why did it go up in flames? Well, there was actually multiple causes. The immediate cause was because there was a static discharge that happened on board the ship as it was coming to dock. This would not have been a bad thing on its own, however, the Hindenburg was full of hydrogen, which is extremely flammable. However, as Mythbusters proved in one of their most famous episodes, the skin of the blimp was also a factor, as the fire reacted to it and caused it to burn at a much faster rate. Oh, and if you're curious as to why the blimp was filled with such flammable gas, it was because the US had an embargo against the Germans and wouldn't let them have the helium they desired to fill the Hindenburg. As such, they used hydrogen, which is lighter than helium. Sadly, this swap, plus other factors, caused not just the death of 36 people, but also the end of blimps as passenger craft. Number 2. Titanic. Surprised to see this legendary ship on here? Well, as in all legendary stories, there's multiple sides to it. Yes, the Titanic hit an iceberg, and there were many factors both before and after that collision that caused it to sink. But one thing that sometimes gets ignored by people is that despite the ship being labeled unsinkable, there was some questionable engineering done that made it anything but. For example, a ship this size had about 3 million rivets holding many things together, right? Well, in 2015, a set of rivets from the Titanic were found and examined, and when they were looked over, it was revealed that they were composed of a very low-grade iron. That's a big, big no-no for an unsinkable ship. And when the iceberg hit the Titanic, the impact caused a lot of cheap rivets to break. And that no doubt helped speed along the process. Another factor was the watertight compartments. These are used on boats like the Titanic to help keep them buoyant. The problem for the Titanic was that these compartments were not exactly sealed properly. They were supposed to be individually sealed. Instead, they were linked via the ceiling. So when the water came in, it filled up the supposedly watertight compartments, and that added a lot of water to an already damaged ship, no doubt causing it to sink at a much faster rate than it would have. So yes, hitting the iceberg was the catalyst, but there were other factors that caused the famous massive ship to sink. Number 1. Chernobyl. There's a lot of things I could have put on the top of this list, but when we talk about things we hope we never have to hear about again, it's hard to beat a nuclear disaster. The Chernobyl nuclear power plant was a fully functioning nuclear plant for basically a decade. It was built in 1977 and was fine for years. Then on April 26, 1986, a routine check of the system started a chain reaction that is still felt to this day. For during that test, a power surge began, one that exposed a structural weakness in reactor number 4 of the plant. The surge, mixed with the weakness, caused an explosion, and this started a chain reaction of more explosions and fires that resulted in a radiation leak from the plant. Said radiation went into the air and the atmosphere, causing a wide range of invisible destruction, as well as visible ones with the explosions and fire. One of the biggest reasons that this is on the top of my list is the fallout. Because of the radiation being leaked into the areas around Chernobyl were infected with radiation that was too dangerous to be around. Nearby towns and areas had to be evacuated. People lost everything because of this. There wasn't a lot of time to pack up their lives either. They just had to leave everything behind. And to this day, the closest town to Chernobyl, a place called Pripyat, is still abandoned, and over 300,000 people had to be relocated to safer areas. This disaster not only re-solidified the dangers of nuclear power, but proved just how disastrous it can be if something went wrong. Needless to say, nations all over the world buckled down their nuclear safety protocols, and thankfully, a nuclear disaster like this hasn't happened since. Thanks for watching. What do you think of these engineering disasters? Do you know of any others that could have been on my list? Let us know in the comments, and be sure to subscribe for more videos like this one, and I'll see you next time.